Hello, YouTube. Okay, well, one of my users, Mark Cranch, was asking about how to set up an LED as part of a PYVCP panel. And I realized that I had done panels showing how to do input buttons, but I hadn't shown how to do an output. So guess what today's video is going to be on? We're going to go over to the PYVCP manual, and I've got this link in the description so you can find it. And they've got all kinds of different things that you can do. One of the things that you can do is, oh my goodness, an LED. We can do a round LED, we can do a rectangle LED, and we can do all kinds of fancy things to it. Alright, we'll do that. These are all the different widgets that you can use. And then one of the things that you can do is images. So you can define some images, and then you can set up a pin, and then you could tell it what image you want. So in this one they made, and it's kind of hard to tell with these images because there's text in them, but they're actually two picture files. So one of them says forward, one of them says reverse. They set up a pin, and then if they get a zero pointed to it, it loads this image forward. If they set the pin the other way, it loads reverse. So later on we'll experiment with doing that. But the first thing we will do is we will come up here and we will look at the LEDs and we'll put an LED in, and then we'll just use a simple round LED. So to be able to do that, we need a machine. And I'm going to start from scratch and step you through at warp speed how we do that. So we'll go into Step Configuration Wizard. We'll start, tell it a new configuration. All right, we're going to call this, we'll call it Probay. All right, XYZ, yeah, that's fine. Inch mode, millimeter, I don't know why, I don't really need it. Got a slow machine, tell it 50 thou, that's fine. We'll go into the pins. I generally set this to amplifier enable. It really doesn't matter, we're not going to use them, but, you know, I'm just being me. I'm not using these. Turn these off. Set the spindle to on. Set these to unused. So this is a typical configuration if you had a simple, you know, three-axis machine. Then we've got some pins, and we usually use these as home inputs, and I use 13 as a e-stop, and then 15 we will set it to a probe input. Okay? So now that's all set up. We go forward. Now, when we get to this one here, we want to have HAL user interface available. We want to have a custom panel. In this case, we're going to just tell it a blank program. All right. Display the panel. Well, there's not going to be much to display. It's a blank panel. We're going to go forward. And as far as the axes go, you're going to have your machine set up, you know, so we'll leave that alone. And now we're done. If you will notice, we've got a file and we've got the actual unit. And if we run this, it's going to come up. And if you look, it doesn't look like much, but you see there's a little gap here. That's because there's a very tiny panel attached. So we're going to go up to the machine. We're going to go to the HAL configuration. This window is going to open up. We're going to come down to signals and expand it, and oh look, we have a probe input signal. And if you look, right now it says the value is true, because in a normal probe, a closed contact is not touching, and an open is touching. And I've got a little switch on here where I can touch it and I can change that, but we'll go to watch and I'll show you. So you see it says, oh, I'm triggered, because it thinks it's triggered, because a normal probe would be normally closed. Anyway, I can push this little simulated button I have, which is connected to my probe input, and I can make it change states. So we know that works. So now what we need to do is create something in our panel. Okay, how do we do that? Well, first thing we're going to do is open up gedit. All right, and we're going to go File, Open, and I'm going to go into my machine, into my Linux CNC folder, which is here. and find my configuration, which is going to be in configs file. Now this is my development machine, so I've got a few in here. Ah, there it is, probe A, and we are going to look for our custom panel and open it up. You can see that in here there's not much going on. There's the start of the panel, there's the end of the panel, and the only thing we've got in between is some kind of a little hello, this is, you know, what it is kind of file. So we're going to go over to the web page, and I'm just going to copy this LED, and I'm going to go in here and I'm going to paste it in. Alright, not very fancy. Now, we'll make a couple little changes. The HAL pin is the name of the device. So when we take a signal, we want to point it to that. We want to say, you will affect this. So we're going to change the name of this to probe status. Alright, so now we've got this device and we've got it called probe status. Alright, we can save that. Now, if we go to the device and we run it, you'll see that we've got this big glaring LED sitting here now. And if I push the button, wait, nothing happens. And the reason nothing happens is because we don't have it pointed to anything. Alright, more work. So we come in here and we go File, Open, and we go and find Custom Post GUI HAL. What this is any kind of little custom signals that you want to make after the main program loads. Yep, and it has a little thing in here that says, hey, this is what this is going to do. There's a spindle at speed, and if you do not have a spindle with an encoder and have it all set up and everything else, Linux CNC will go in there and set it as true so that your stuff will run. Just leave it. All right, so now we've got our little custom HAL. And we know that we've got this thing called probe status. We want to hook a signal to it, right? Alright, so we remember, if we do a net, that's like nets two things together, we had a signal called probe in. Remember? We looked at that. And then we say, I want you to send a signal to, ta-da, probe status. But it's a little more than just probe status. That probe status happens to live in our PYVCP panel. All right? That's it. It can't be that easy, can it? Let's find out. So we've got a panel with an LED. We've got a code that says if this signal changes, push it to the panel, whatever this signal is. So let's go in. Let's open it up. We got a green LED. What happens if I push the probe? Oh, look at that. It changes states. Isn't that lovely? Ugly as sin, but it works. So that's how you do the panel. All right? Now we'll get artsy-fartsy. Did a little drawing. Let's take a look at what we've got. We go into Linux CNC, configs, go to your configuration file, and you see now I've created a directory called images. In there I've got the SVG high resolution images that we use to create the bitmaps, alright? And then I've got the actual bitmaps themselves. There's one with the probe down, there's one with the probe up. Alright? Just bear that in mind, and it's called probe-up and probe-down, and they're both PNG. So now, we go in here and we look at what is required to make an image. Alright? I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to jump over here to the custom panel. You notice in here we had linked it to something called probe status. So if we use the same name, we should be good. So we're going to drop this in here for now. Alright? And so the first image that we're going to have, we're going to call it probe up. The second image, G. We're going to call it probe down. All right, no rocket science there. Now for the file name. Okay, so for the file name, I have to say from where you're at, go to a directory called images. All right, once inside of there, look for a drawing called probe-up.png. All right, the other one, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to say starting from where you're at, look for a directory called images. And we're going to look for probe-dn.png. All right? That tells it where the two images are. Okay? I'm not going to worry about... I guess I should. I'll leave the VBox in there and we'll go through and explain what that is. So now, the HAL pin, we're going to use this name. And we're going to put it in here. All right. I don't need the LED anymore. In fact, leaving it in would cause an error. Okay. So, what we have is two parts to this. The first part is we define what our image names are going to be and the physical image that it points to. Then we've got our HAL pin, and we're going to reuse the HAL pin that we've already used here. Okay. Now, in here it says, hey, what images do you want me to use? Well, in the normal mode, I want to use the probe up image. And if the probe is down, I want to use the probe down image. All right. Now, this VBox, I hadn't covered it before, but technically speaking, when you make a panel, you want to make a vertical box, and it'll stack things one on top of the other. And then if you want things horizontally, you make an H-box, and it stacks it that way. You can look at my last two videos that covered how to lay that stuff out in a PYVCP panel, and I'll put the links down there in the description. So anyway, we've got this set up. We're going to save it, right? That can't be all there is to it. Let's find out. Let's run the probe. Hey, look at that. There's a picture of a probe up here. What happens if I play with the button? Oh, look at that. Isn't that fancy? And I made this 200 pixels wide because I figured you might want to have some extra buttons and stuff in here. But say that you did not. Say that you wanted this thing to be a little bit smaller, right? Not a problem. All we have to do is go into our source program, Inkscape, and recreate the images, and we can make them any size we want. Okay, so I changed the image size to 50 pixels wide to make it a little bit more usable for you in case you wanted something smaller. Alright, so there you go. You've got a probe indicator. Yay! So, that concludes this lesson. If you managed to create a great panel, then please let me know. I'd be glad to see it. Thank you, and have a great day. Subscribe!